Good morning, Jesus School family. Are you grateful to be in the presence of Jesus this morning? We want to welcome everyone watching online from around the world. Thank you for joining us. We're just going to step in and worship the King this morning. If you just want to lift your hands and just begin to lift your gaze on the Lord, Jesus, we thank you this morning. We come into your presence, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that in your presence is fullness of joy, and at your right hand there are pleasures forevermore, Lord. So we just come to honor you. We come to bless your name, Jesus. We come to thank you, Lord, for the cross and for the blood that you shed that we might be brought near. We thank you, Lord, for your presence filling this room today. We pray, Holy Spirit, glorify the name of Jesus this morning. Be lifted up in this room, Lord. Every eye seeing and beholding the King of Glory. We honor you and we worship you this morning, Jesus. We give you all of the praise and all of the glory. And we love you, Jesus. Amen.
Except the cross of Jesus Christ. riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice. It's a year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice. It's a year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes.
Declaring the word of the Lord. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. Yeah, there's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no God like Jehovah.
See? pride say, come. The Spirit and the pride say, come. The Spirit and the pride say, come. Come and come quickly.
Creation is groaning, longing for thee.
Eternity's close, closer than we think. What are they singing? What is it like? You are surrounded with thunder and light. Everything in us, the longing, the ache to join with the heavens, the anthem of praise. Holy. Blessing and honor and glory and power belong to you. Holy, holy, holy are you.
Jesus. We love your name. We love you, Jesus. There's something that happens in a room when the name of Jesus is lifted on high. His name is an ointment poured forth. Jesus, we love you. We thank you for loving us. Oh, how we love you, Lord. There is none like you, Lord. Whom have we in heaven but you? There is none upon the earth whom we desire but you, Lord. We thank you for your love. We thank you for coming. We love you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. I really felt this as I was coming up that we should give something so costly to the Lord. Can we just praise Jesus? Come on, can we lift a praise, a shout of praise to Jesus? Come on. Head back to your seats. How many of you are so happy that he has delivered you from the domain of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved son? And I don't know about you, but as we were ministering to the Lord and we were singing Days of Elijah, there was such a freedom in the room. Yes. And it's so fitting that we are about to enter into Holy Communion, which is the meal of love, the meal of deliverance. And he is our Passover lamb. And so today I just want you to behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This morning as I was getting ready, I could hear the words of Jesus when he looks to Philip and says, "Where are we to buy bread?" And this meal, this bread, there is no need to purchase this bread, for the bread of life has purchased us. And unlike Eve, who eats from the tree of knowledge of good and evil for selfish wisdom and individualism, today we partake of the tree of life where Christ is suspended. And he invites all to freely feast upon him, to take his body and to drink of his blood. Jesus, you say in your word that you are the bread that has come down from heaven. And anyone who eats of this bread, he will live forever. The bread that you give for the life of the world is your flesh. And today, as we eat of your flesh, we receive by virtue wholeness and healing. We receive life eternal, love incorruptible. Thank you, Jesus, for inviting us to not only a table, but to the person of Christ. You are the great high priest who rules over God's house. You are the meal. Thank you, Jesus, for healing bodies this morning. Thank you, Jesus, for those that are watching online, whether you be in a prison cell or in a hospital, maybe you feel captive.
But today we are partaking of the meal of deliverance. We have exiled the world and we have been transferred into the kingdom of the beloved Son, Jesus. By faith, we give you, we offer up our bodies, and in exchange, we receive your body. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus. In chapter 19, verse 33, it says, "But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and immediately blood and water came out. And he who has seen testified, and his testimony is true, and he knows that he is telling the truth, so that you may believe, for these things were done, that the scripture should be fulfilled. Not one of his bones shall be broken." And again, another scripture says, "They shall look on him whom they pierced." Jesus, we just thank you for the blood. And we just lift it, Father. Lord, we remember what you did on the cross for us, Jesus. We remember, Jesus, your side being pierced. We remember your blood, God, that you died, Father, for us, Jesus, that you saw us, Lord, on that cross, that you knew us, Jesus. We thank you, God, for the blood of Jesus that covers us, that protects us and has made us whole. We thank you, Jesus, that you covered our sins with your blood, Father. We thank you, Jesus, for dying. We thank you, Jesus, for the revelation of the cross. We thank you, Jesus, because you are so worthy. You're so holy, Father. And so we acknowledge, Father, today. We acknowledge in our hearts, Jesus, that you died on the cross for us. That, Jesus, your blood was shed for us, God, because you loved us, Jesus. And so your blood, Father, makes us whole. We believe in the mighty name of Jesus for our bodies to be whole in Jesus' name, for our minds to be whole in the name of Jesus. We just thank you that your blood was shed on the cross for our sins and for our pain, Jesus. And so, Lord, we love you. We love you. We exalt your name, God. We just thank you, Father, for the cross. And we just come into agreement, Lord, with all that you've done, all that you've done, Jesus. We love you, Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You're so worthy. Your name is truly beautiful, Lord. We love you, Lord. We're aware that you have come so near to us this morning, Lord, and I pray that we would give you a proper response this morning, Lord. Would you stir up thankfulness, Lord, in our hearts this morning? Would you stir up generosity in us, Lord, this morning? We thank you, Lord. We remember your cross and your sacrifice, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, guys, we're going to step into a time of giving now. It's really holy in here. And I was just sitting there and so aware the Lord has met us this morning. He really has. He's come so near. And my heart was stirred. And I said, I want to give you a response this morning, Lord. You've blessed us this morning with yourself. And I was reading this morning in Luke 5. When the Lord, you know, tells Peter to cast his net out again and he's tired. We can turn there and read it real quick. Luke 5 and starting in verse 4, it says, "And when he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, 'Put out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch.' And Simon answered, Master, we toiled all night and took nothing, but at your word, I will let down the nets. And when they had done this, they enclosed a large number of fish, and their nets were breaking. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both of the boats so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees saying, Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. For he and all who were with him were astonished at the catch that they had taken. And if you skip down, Jesus replies to Simon and he says, Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching men. And when they had brought their boats to land, they left everything they had and they followed Jesus. And I was reading this morning and the Lord made it aware to me, when I choose to trust the Lord over my toils, my anxiety, my fear, something happens to me. Yeah, a blessing, you know, we are blessed when we give, but something happens in my heart too. And so Peter, when he chose to obey the Lord, he saw Jesus as he was. He saw him as Lord and he said, I'm a sinful man. But the Lord responded, do not have fear. And I wanna trust the Lord this morning. And I was thinking back even to my first year when me and my wife moved here in 2020. And it was the middle of COVID and election season. And I was letting so many things speak to my heart and it was affecting my giving. I had so much fear in my heart. And I needed to look at the tree and let that speak to me above anything else. Because when I look there, I see that I, in terms of giving, I'm giving to the one who's given me everything. I'm giving to the most trustworthy one. I'm giving to the one that I say with my lips and I believe in my heart that I'm trusting him to raise my body when he comes back. I trust him every day to wash away my sin. How much more should I trust him with my giving? And that 1 John 4 verse 18 started to become real to me, that perfect love casts out all fear because the one who has fear has not been perfected in love. But when I look at the tree, instead of what's around me, instead of my bank account, my fear and my toil, I say, wow, he loves me and he's trustworthy. And I can give to him today because he's given me everything. And so this morning, I just wanna pray for you guys. Lord Jesus, would you truly let us, Lord, direct our hearts to look at the tree, Lord. You bloodied a tree, Lord Jesus, for us because you love us. Would you perfect our hearts this morning in your love, Lord? Let all fear leave. We can trust you, Lord Jesus. We give, Lord, because you gave. You gave us everything. And it is our natural response now, Lord Jesus, in you to be givers, to be generous, Lord. We trust you, Lord, with our life. We trust you with our money. We trust you to raise us, to cleanse us, Lord. Thank you for your life. Thank you for your death, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If you guys are in the room and you want to give, we're going to have the buckets. You can rush the buckets here. If you're online, you'll have a prompt on your screen where you can give that way too. So yeah, thank you guys. And before we let you guys go on the live stream, we do have a very exciting announcement that we have preview day coming up on March 28th. Just see it on your screen. And following preview day, we are going to have Good Friday, and we're gonna have that Sunday, that next Sunday morning is Easter Sunday, so we would love if you were in town just to hit it all with us that week. If you wanna know what Jesus School is like, you can come and you can see it here live on Thursday, March the 28th. And preview day is special to me because my brother came to a preview day and he decided to come to Jesus School. And I always wanted to do Jesus School with my little brother. And so he came, so you guys in the room, you know, you can let your siblings know too. So yeah, and to our live stream family, we're going to see you again Sunday morning at 10 a.m.
We believe that the nations will descend on this land.
That the sick will be healed here.
That the lost will be saved here.
That the presence of the glory of God will rest here.
Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down. That the mountains might shake at your presence.
That the gospel will go forth from here.
Shaking the earth for the glory of God.
That the presence of Jesus Christ would dwell among us.
Here we will enter into the peace of your presence. Here we will remain. Jesus said, remain in me and I in you.
Here we will remain.
This is holy ground.
Where only one thing is needed. Jesus.
May Jesus be pleased with all that takes place here. May he be adored and worshiped here. May his word be taught in clarity and love here.
As we tell the generations to come the praises of the Lord and his strength and his wonderful works he has done.
May the generations come to find him here.
To find Jesus here.
Here. Together we will build the house of God.
And a home for his people.